Hi, I'm Graham Zimmerman, Phoenix Contact Automation Product Manager at Airline Hydraulics Corporation. Today, we're configuring the Phoenix Contact mGuard router for remote connectivity via the Phoenix Contact Secure Cloud Service. We'll be configuring the mGuard in 6 easy steps. The first step is to create an account on the mGuard Secure Cloud website at us.cloud.mguard.com. Enter all information and remember your password for future use. On the machine network page, enter the IP address of the network you will be connecting to remotely. For example, if the devices in the network will be on the 192.168.1 network, set it as 192.168.1.0 with a net mask of 255.255.255.0 to lock in the first 3 octets. Before moving to step 2, I want to clarify the terminology used on the Secure Cloud website. The service workstation is one side of the VPN tunnel that you will use to tunnel into the Secure Cloud from your VPN client software on your computer. For this configuration video, we will be setting up the free VPN client software, Shrewsoft, as the service workstation to tunnel into the Secure Cloud. The service target is the other side of the VPN tunnel, where the mGuard end device is connected. For this configuration video, we will focus on setting up an mGuard as the service target to tunnel into the other side of the Secure Cloud tunnel. So, think service workstation as Shrewsoft and the service target as the mGuard you want to remote into. Once both of these are connected to the Secure Cloud, you will now have a full bridge of communication from your computer to the mGuard. Step 2 is to create your service workstation configuration profile. To tunnel from your VPN client software called Shrewsoft to the Secure Cloud, a configuration profile will need to be created, downloaded, and imported into Shrewsoft for communication to the Secure Cloud. On the Secure Cloud website, click on Service Workstation at the top of the website. Click on the plus beside all service workstations to add a service workstation. Add a workstation name that identifies what this will be. For example, I will be naming this Graham Shrewsoft, which identifies this as my Shrewsoft VPN client workstation. After the workstation is created, click on the VPN builder icon. Select Shrewsoft VPN client as the VPN client type. Next, enter a password that you will remember under client password. Under machine network, enter the IP address of the network you will be connecting to. For example, the devices I will be connecting to on the local side of this mGuard will be on the 192.168.1 network. So I will enter 192.168.1.0, followed by a net mask of 255.255.255.0. After you've entered this information, press Request. And save this configuration file to your computer in an area where you will know this is your Shrewsoft configuration file. Step 3 is to download Shrewsoft and upload the service workstation configuration profile we just created. To download the free VPN client software called Shrewsoft, there is a link in the description below to the Shrewsoft website. Once downloaded and installed, go to File, Import, and select the configuration file you downloaded from the Secure Cloud website. We will come back to TrueSoft later in this video to start the VPN tunnel, but for now, move on to step 4. Step 4 is to create your service target configuration profile. To tunnel from the Secure Cloud to the mGuard device, you will need to create another configuration profile under Service Targets on the Secure Cloud website and upload this to the mGuard. To do so, start by clicking on the Service Targets tab at the top of the Secure Cloud website. Next, click on the icon next to the Active VPNs tab. Then, click on the plus icon next to Active VPNs. Fill out the appropriate information. Click on the plus icon under the newly created workstation. Fill out the information to add a new machine to this location. Next, click on the wrench icon underneath the newly created machine. Once inside the VPN builder, select Router under mGuard mode, as we are trying to set up a hardwired mGuard in this configuration video. Next, under VPN connection, you have the option to select the standard IPsec ports of UDP 500 and 4500, or the secure HTTP port TCP 443, as the mGuard can use different ports to make the outbound connection to the Secure Cloud. For this example, we will use the secure HTTP port TCP 443. Under external network, select dynamic IP address. Next, under internal network, input the IP address of the LAN or local side of the mGuard you're trying to set up. Earlier in this video, we selected subnet 192.168.1.0, so set the LAN side of this mGuard at 192.168.1.1. Lastly, hit the request button and download the service target configuration file for the mGuard. Save this in a folder that identifies it as the mGuard configuration file. Step 5 is to upload the service target configuration profile to the mGuard. From a hardware perspective, each mGuard has a WAN and a LAN port. The WAN port is a wide area network port that connects to the internet, and the LAN port is a local area network that connects to all your devices on the local side. Be sure that your mGuard is powered up with a clean 24 volts, and then plug the internet side into your WAN port and your local computer into the LAN port. To connect to the mGuard, be sure that your computer is on the 192.168.1 network, as the default IP address of the mGuard is 192.168.1.1. Once your computer is on the 192.168.1 network, open up a web browser. Type in https://192.168.1.1 and the web page for the mGuard should appear. To log in, use the default username admin and default password mGuard with a capital G. After logging in, click on Management on the left-hand side of the main page. Click on Configuration Profiles. Select Choose File and find the configuration you just downloaded from the Secure Cloud website for the mGuard service target. Select Upload. Once uploaded, you will see the file underneath Factory Default. On the same row as the configuration file, select the Restore button. After doing so, you will see a green arrow show up next to the configuration file. Your mGuard is now able to be routed to from the Secure Cloud. Step 6 is to start the full VPN from the ShrewSoft client to the mGuard. Make sure your computer has access to the internet. Also, make sure your mGuard is connected on the WAN side to a viable internet source. In a web browser, go back to the us.cloud.mguard.com website and keep it open. Reopen the ShrewSoft VPN client software on your computer. Start the VPN tunnel from the ShrewSoft software to the secure cloud by double-clicking on the configuration file and entering the password you created earlier in this guide. After logging in, you should see a screen that states the tunnel is enabled, which means you are routing from the computer to the secure cloud. After the tunnel is enabled on ShrewSoft, go back to the secure cloud website while keeping ShrewSoft running on your computer. After a few seconds, the first box on the secure cloud website will turn green, indicating a connection from ShrewSoft to the secure cloud. Under Active VPNs, you will see the mGuard you set up with a green start button next to it. Click on the green start button. You will see that all three boxes in the top left-hand corner turn green, which means you are routing from your computer to the mGuard. After you have successfully routed from your computer to the mGuard, you will now be able to fully communicate with the devices on the local side of the mGuard. So, we're successfully routed from our computer to the mGuard, so we'll be able to fully communicate with the devices on the local side of the mGuard. Visit www.airlinehide.com, where you can find the mGuard and other products by Phoenix Contact. If you find that you have any questions about this tutorial, let me know in the comments below. If you like this video, be sure to subscribe to Airline's YouTube channel for the latest information on products and technologies to save you time and money. Thank you.